Hello, and welcome to Serverless.net, the show where we code a complete microservice from scratch using AWS, lambda, Dotnet, dynamodb, and we're deploying it all with CDK. Okay, so we're up to episode 7. We're getting near the end of this series, so in this episode we want to finish off our check endpoint. So we're going to be verifying our verifying that the password is valid, that it's not already verified, that it hasn't expired, hasn't exceeded max attempts, and updating the verification in Dynamo to set it as verified or incrementing the attempts if incorrect codes pass through. So, might as well just grab these to-do items and bring them over into code and paste them here, and so this can become a bit of a plan. Right, so let's just kind of work our way through these. Okay, first one. I'm just going to change this to say not found. So checking for already verified. So on our verification class, we have this verified date time. So if that's not null, sorry, if it has a value already, because this is a nullable date time, so it's got a little question mark on it. Then what we can say is, I guess already verified, and then checking expired is pretty easy. We already have our expired calculated properties. If we go have a look at this. What we're doing is taking the delta between the time now and when it was first created, and if that's greater than 3 minutes, then it's expired. Can remove these comments because it's kind of pretty easy to read. Verification expired, already verified, expired. Yeah, we'll just say expired. Checking max attempts. So maybe we can just say you can have 3 attempts for now. Did I spell exceeded right? I don't know why I can't spell that. Attempt succeeded. In this 3, we can make this be configurable through environment variables. So I haven't shown how to do that yet. Maybe we'll look at doing that in another episode or at the end of this episode. It's pretty simple to do. Yeah, we'll do that at the end. Validating. I'll just leave it to do so I don't forget. So to validate our password, oh, I can get rid of this delay now as well. Don't need that. We new up our one-time password class. And we've loaded our verification out of the database, so that's where the secret key is. So what we want to do is call verify on it. So the request, the check request will have the password on it. And we need to use the current verification's version number. So if not true, so if it's not valid, what we want to do is return and we need to do this here, increment attempts against that verification. So we'll update this record in Dynamo to increment the attempts property. And then finally, here we need to mark this, like if we're here, we're good. So we need to mark our verification. We need to set the date here. And that's pretty much it. So what we need to do here is call await increment attempts. And we're going to need the verifications phone and the version so that we can look it up. So we'll make that a method, and then here we want to say set verification verified. It's a bit of a mouthful, but it's all good. Right, so what we're going to be doing here is a update request. So do we have an update request anywhere? We do. So what we want to do here is say var request equals new update. I think it's update item request, yeah. And I don't need that. So it's going to be our table. Our version needs to go in here. And don't think we need a condition expression. So what we're going to be doing here is saying set attempts equals attempts plus some value. I don't know if you can do plus equals one. Like, be good if you could just do that. I don't know if you can. Set attempts equals attempts plus value, and then in here we need to give it a value, and we're just going to be putting one, so we're incrementing it by one. Oh, underscore DDB. Okay. Update item. Give it our request. Make this async. Right. So that's that one. And then we also need our set verification. We could just say set verified, I guess. And we're going to be doing pretty much the same thing. And we'll be setting verified equals verified. And We're also going to increment attempts as well, because I guess even though you've just so that it's kind of consistent in the database, so it took you one attempt to actually successfully verify it. So it won't say zero in there, it'll say one if you got it right the first time. So what we need to do here is have another row which has the verified date in it. So it's going to be a string, and we do date time dot UTC now dot toString with the ISO formatter in there. I think that's how we did dates. Let's have a quick look. So that's how we did created, yeah. So set verified equals verified, and attempts equal to attempts plus value. Value is one. So that looks good to me. Set verified. All right. So should we just let's do a verification here. Oh no, wait, I don't have the code. Yeah, we need to do this. It's kind of hard to write a test for this because it sends the code to our phone. So what we could do, which would be kind of cool, is actually mock out the call to SNS, and we could actually record the number that got generated. Should be one way of doing it. I guess we could just deploy it as well and manually test it, and then swing around and add some proper testing. So if we do .NET build, oh, let's also do this to-do item that we had, which was making this environment variable. So what we could do here when the function's first constructed, we could say max attempts. We do environment dot get environment variable, what we could do if string actually we could just do a try pass. Okay, so what we're doing here is if an environment variable is present called max attempts, happens to have a integer in it, what will this try pars will succeed and we'll set max attempts to max. Otherwise, we'll be setting it to 3. Okay, so now I need to switch back over to CDK and provide this environment variable. So each lambda has an environment property on it. So we're just going to supply Okay, so let's redeploy it. Okay, so if we jump over to Postman now. Got our phone number, so let's send a text. Just see if I've actually. Grab this. Check endpoint. I'm not actually receiving the text messages right now. I'm being throttled by AWS. If you go down here, what's the date today? The 14th. Yeah, it's not actually sending them because I've got limits on my account. So anyway, what we can do, over in Lambda, we just look at the logs to find out what that code was. Right, fingers crossed that's the right one. So 6161. Right, let's do it. Okay, so that said verified true. Let's jump over to Dynamo and have a look if we got verified. So the latest version is 4.6.1. Hey, look, verified. So we can now test trying to re-verify the same one. We should get back an error. There we go. So already verified. Cool. So then I guess the next thing we could do is send a new verification. And this time, like, try and trip our max attempts check. So if we put that in and then we put in a bogus number, should do invalid code 2, 3, and then on the fifth, there we go, attempt succeeded. So did that take 4 attempts? I can't remember. But let's have a look in Dynamo. So for this one here, which is 4D, says we did 4 attempts. Oh yeah, because we said greater than 3. All right. So we know that's working. And the thing to test now, which is this first function, is this bit here where if we were to guess we need to make a decision on this case here. So like if I try to create a new verification right now, it's still going to return me this one, even though you've exceeded the attempts against this one. So I guess that's probably right. It's what we want to do. Like we don't want to give out another verification. Or do we? So I guess we'd need some kind of basically what I'm trying to work out here is that if you're trying to create a new one and the current one has expired or has already been verified, the other one we need to look at is, or if you've exceeded your attempts, and if you have exceeded your attempts, then maybe we just create a new one. I'm not sure if that's, well, we probably need it because otherwise you'll never be able to unblock yourself, because it's always just going to return. Oh no, you'll just wait till it's expired, I guess. Yeah, you just have to wait till it expires. No, that's fine, because it'll be 3 minutes. Once 3 minutes up, it'll create a new one. So, back at start, I don't know if it's been 3 minutes yet, but let's see. Yeah, there we go. It's version 6. And if we tried to start that again, we'll get the same one, A4. Okay, so looks pretty good to me. I'm forgetting if there's other stuff we want to expired. We could test that, I guess. But we'd have to wait 3 minutes. Cool. What else can we do? I think we'll probably just end it there. And then the next episode we can look at building this verification status endpoint, and all that does is you can pass it an ID and it'll just give you back the phone number and whether or not it's verified. So it should be pretty simple to build. And we could probably do some more refactoring and tidying up some of the stuff, like in here. This is duplicated in a couple of places. So it's duplicated there and here. And yeah, there's just a bit of code duplication, some tidy up that we could do. Anyway, I think we'll end it there. Thanks for watching. See you later.